My name is Alberto Isla, and I'm an upper GI surgeon working in London. During the last 25 years, I've been a consultant surgeon at London Northwest Healthcare. And for the last 10 years, my practice has been focused almost exclusively on hiatal surgery and complex benign biliary, especially laparoscopic bile duct exploration. I have performed close to 1,000 anti-reflux procedures. What is laparoscopic anti-reflux surgery? Gastroesophageal reflux disease, GERD, is a common condition where acid from the stomach leaks up into the esophagus, gullet. It usually occurs as a result of the ring of muscle at the bottom of the esophagus becoming weakened. Normally, this ring of muscle opens to let food into your stomach and closes to stop stomach acid leaking back up into your esophagus. But with people with GERD, stomach acid is able to pass back into the esophagus. This causes symptoms of GERD, which can include heartburn and acid reflux. It is not always clear what causes this ring of muscle to become weakened, but certain things can increase the risk of it happening. The following factors may increase your risk of developing: being overweight or obese, also eating large amount of fatty foods, smoking, alcohol, coffee or chocolate. This may relax the muscle at the bottom of the esophagus. Pregnancy, temporary changes in hormone levels and increased pressure on your stomach during pregnancy can cause GERD. Hiatus hernia, when a part of your stomach pushes up through your diaphragm, which is the thin sheet of muscle between the chest and the tummy. Gastroparesis, that is when the stomach takes longer to get rid of stomach acid, which means excess acid can leak up into the esophagus. Some medicines can cause GERD or make the symptoms worse, including calcium channel blockers used to treat high blood pressure, nitrates used to treat angina, and non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs. And also, GERD can sometimes affect several members of the same family, and it has been suggested that the genes you inherit from your parents may also affect your chances of developing the condition. Who needs anti-reflux surgery? The main indications for anti-reflux surgery are patients with proven GERD that don't respond to medication, patients that don't wish to take the medication or are intolerant to the medication, patients with regurgitation or volume reflux. What does the surgery involve? Your operation will be carried out by laparoscopy or keyhole surgery. This means it is carried out using special surgical instruments, 3 and 5 millimeters in diameter, that are inserted through small cuts in the skin. It is carried out in a hospital under general anesthetic. The surgeon will, first of all, restore the stomach back into the abdomen, then restore a sufficient length of esophagus in the abdomen. This will be followed by narrowing the opening in the diaphragm, and finally create a new valve at the lower end of the gullet by using a mobile part of the stomach called the fundus. During surgery, the fundus of the stomach is wrapped around the lower part of the esophagus to an extent of 180 degrees. This called the Tupper wrap. Rarely, we perform 360 or 90 degree wraps. Are there any complications? As in every surgical procedure, there is a small risk with the anesthetic and the operation itself, such as bleeding, perforation of the esophagus or stomach, pulmonary embolisms, which are clots in the lungs, vagal damage, that is the injury of one of the nerves that run alongside the esophagus, and can affect the way the stomach empties. We perform this surgery regularly, and we have a great track record for safely carrying it out. In the past 25 years, patients have experienced minimal complications and have not experienced any major direct esophageal perforation, which is accidentally making a hole in the gullet during the procedure. Are there any side effects? Most patients will be fit to go home within 24 hours of surgery and will recover better at home where they feel most comfortable. Please do not expect to swallow or eat normally immediately after your operation. It may take up to 3 months to swallow or eat normally. It is also not unusual to experience some degree of abdominal, chest, or shoulder tip discomfort. All this immediately after your operation. So please, do not be alarmed, as this is perfectly normal. Every patient is different, but as a general rule, in the first 48 to 72 hours after your operation, drink only clear fluid like water, black tea, coffee. Up to 6 weeks after your operation, please step up from liquid to puree to soft diet as tolerated. However, if you are struggling at any stage, please stop down to a level to the previous diet. Remember to eat slowly and chew your food thoroughly before swallowing. Liquid diet is a broth or soup. Puree diet is anything blended and without lumps. Soft diet, for instance, flaky fish. It is important that you avoid fizzy drinks, bread, chunks of meat, and rice until the end of the recovery period. Are there any alternatives to the procedure? As mentioned at the beginning, surgery is the alternative to medical treatment. There are other treatments, as magnetic rings, etc., but they are invasive and without the very well-tested outcomes of fundoplication.